Hello, today I would like to discuss the important topic, which especially is important because of the increase in the interest rates and significant exposure of banks to the interest rate risk at the current environment. So I would like to discuss the pipeline hedging program, prepayment hedging, and also subsequently, maybe not today, but structural hedging. So these are quite important three types of hedges which needs to be put in place in this volatile market environment. So let's start. First of all, let's see what happened in the market today. Then we will define what is the pipeline risk and what does it mean to be exposed to the pipeline risk. We will be talking a bit more in detail about what is the pipeline hedging modeling, because obviously in order to hedge we need to model it first. Then we will be going through the different pipeline hedging strategies, and eventually we will talk about the prepayment risk. So first of all, what happened in the market, everyone knows 2022, we had the significant shift in the interest rates, and we know that both in UK and in Eurozone we have seen over the 8 months around or 9 months around 300 or more than 300 basis points increase in rates. So this is even higher than the current IRRBB stress test required by the regulator is doing. By it's shocking the curve by more than 200 basis point and 250 basis point. Instead, the market rates moved up by more than 300 basis point. So this already said extent of the event. So indeed, I personally believe that at the moment we are living quite unusual black swan event. And we had also some new, some more news, not only the 2022 increase, which was driven by the by inflation, which was driven by war, but today and last week we had the news about the failure of the American bank, Silicon Valley Bank, and we have also heard about the problems in the Swiss bank, which resulted in the market uncertainty and volatility. So today it was really very difficult to trade any swap because of the market volatility. So you really need to be stuck to the to Bloomberg, to the market rates provider, in order to be able to execute any transaction because of the volatility, because it was moving so fast, up and down, and this obviously shows you how volatile the market is, how uncertain the market is. Also today we had big news about the hike in central bank rate by 50 basis point in Europe, in Eurozone. So which means obviously that central bank is committed to the subsequent hikes in interest rates, and because they want to fight inflation. Instead, there was some discussion what will happen today. Maybe there will be some pause in terms of the interest rate increase because of the turmoil in the market, because what has happened to the Silicon Valley Bank and all recent news, because the banking system is under scrutiny now, and we know that we have also the stress testing in Europe. So many, many things going on. But coming back to the point, we see this this shift in the curve. And obviously, as I said, this is by tenor, so you can see which tenor was the most affected. So we see that the curve is obviously inverted at the moment. What does it mean, the inverted shape? Inverted shape is not common at all. It's it's not normal, I should say, not common, but not normal, because usually we are expecting the positive premium, market premium, the longer tenor is. Instead, today we have the short end of the curve, which price higher rate than medium long end of the curve, which shows you how uncertain the market is about the future. So this means that the market discounts the potential future recession and the fact that the inflation and the high interest rate environment will impact potentially the cost of living and household keeping budgets. So this is why we the market discounts, not only for this reason, but this is one of the reasons why market is discounting this rate cut in the future, and why we have the rate inverted. So we see that in the which tenor was the most affected. So we have quite significant shift in terms of the 1 year tenor of the curve, and it is for both currencies, I should say. It's for Europe and for GBP. What does it mean if you have this kind of shift in the rates? You have the exposure not only to the structural interest rate risk, so on the medium long end of the curve, but potentially if you are originated mortgages and mortgages at fixed rate, this means that you are probably exposed to the pipeline risk. And the reason for this is because, especially in case of mortgages, the time of the application and the time for actually completion or drawdown of the loan could be from 1 to even 6 months. So this is the period when you are doing the first, you are doing through the offer, then there is some kind of, you know, evaluation, then there is the time when this goes to the lawyer, and there is the, at least I'm talking about the stages in UK, and then you finally you go to the completion. But there is always this time span when you could be potentially exposed to the interest rate risk if the rates move sharply up. And this is what happened recently. So we have seen the rates moving shortly up. So imagine people who got offered the rate in February 2022, and then people, you know, after 6 months, the bank would find itself with market rates higher by 300 basis points. Yeah, so obviously this mortgage could be potentially not profitable anymore for the bank. So this obviously needs some thought, and this needs to be hedged, and there are strategies to hedge the pipeline risk, or I call it strategies, but basically it's the basic, let's say, procedure how to hedge this kind of risk. And first of all, in order to hedge it, you need to model it. And what does it mean? Because we know that this is the subject to behavioralization. And what does it mean? This means that there is the unconditional movement, driven by the rates increase or decrease. So potentially, if the speed of rates increase is higher, then you can, or is growing or is speeding up, then you can see higher drawdown, because obviously customer wants to crystallize or put in place the lower rate which they negotiated with the bank, which they closed, which they fixed. So obviously for them it's good news that they are cheaper loan, but for the bank it's not good news. So this is obviously two sides of the coin. So we would need to model the pipeline risk exposure, and first of all, in order to model it, you need to have the access to data. And as always, having data is of utmost importance for the bank in order to do any analysis, behavioral analysis. So this is, we already said that this is the subject to behavioralization. There is the potential change in the behavior of the customer driven by the speed of rates moving up or down. And the pipeline needs to be understood. So what is the potential drawdown under current rates environment, the moving up environment. So and then we should potentially understand what if the rates start moving faster up or sharply move down. So how potentially it could impact the drawdown of the loan. So once we have this this modeling done, so for example, we know that X percentage of the certain stage of our pipeline will complete, because not always 100% or even not 50% will be drawn down, because there is always some drop off in the journey because, for example, customer changed his mind or because bank by the end not accepted something, or because the fee was not paid on time. So there is always some drop off. So we need to understand the percentage of loans which will be subject to drawdown, or at least this is our expectation of the drawdown of mortgages. And before going into the hedging strategy, once we modeled those items, we know that we need to start hedging. But before we move to hedging, I wanted also to say that some banks do not even consider the pipeline risk, in the sense that they don't hedge it. And this was the quite catastrophic. This was catastrophic for banks, at least in UK. Because in 2022, because as you know, after mini budget, famous mini budget in UK, the rates shortly move up, and you know the bank faced losses in terms of the loans which has been fixed before before this event. So if banks were not hedged through the pipeline hedges, then there was definitely some crystallized loss in terms of the impact on, because you are committed as a bank, you are committed and you have to deliver this loan to the customer or originate to this loan to the customer. And this is exactly, we need to understand where is the point of commitment. Once we understood here at this point of the stage we are committed, then understand the stage and then start modeling this particular, from this particular stage onward. Also, I would like to say that leaving the exposure to the pipeline risk could be really disastrous, because you would really face the negative P&L. And I'm going to show you exactly how we calculate the P&L impact of the pipeline, and with and without hedges. But this is for the next session. Thank you.